Good morning. Welcome back. What a great message today by Pastor Roberto. Thank you for staying with us and joining with us this morning. An approach to worship in the right way. Pastor Roberto spoke today about a worship menu, and maybe we never even thought about it that way, but we have the mentality of the consumer a lot of times, and sometimes we bring that into our worship setting. I know I'm guilty of it just as much as anybody else is, but you go into a worship type setting in the sanctuary or at a church or whatever, and you sit down, and it's kind of like you're there for the entertainment value of it or something. Like, what do you got for me today? And worship is not about what we get, but what is it that we're going to bring? And so many times we walk away from our worship experience like, well, geez, that didn't really do anything for me today. Well, what did you bring? What did you bring to the worship instead of what did you get out of the worship? Because it's all about working together. And when you bring something, when you actually do what Paul said in his verse in Romans 12 today, you are the living sacrifice to God. So you need to bring that. And that helps you transform. And Pastor Roberto did a great job today talking about that. He said worship is measured by how much we leave. So when we come, we bring. And how much did we leave? It's not how much did we take out of it. It's how much we left there at the altar, at the feet. I think the question is for a lot of us today is, it's not so much what and how are we going to sing today to worship, but it's what am I bringing to worship so that we can sing today? You get where that was going? Awesome message today. It's something for us to think about, especially as we are going through this time of transition. We're kind of doing this hybrid of in-person worship and worshiping at home online here at New Hope Online. And there's different designs of how we worship now. We've been kind of set into motion as to, okay, well, if you feel it's best to worship from home, how are you going to worship? Are you going to click around and shop around for the best bells and whistles to give you the great worship songs of the day? Or are you going to find that worship service that is really an invitation for you to bring what is the living sacrifice to God? Just some things to think about. I think we do a pretty good job here in bringing to you a great platform to come in and bring that living sacrifice and to have the capability to transform. I believe we do that here, and I hope we do that for you at home and online here at New Hope. So many things that were great in that service. I don't know if you caught or not the great diversity that our worship and praise team does have. But they did a little song today, and they did it in different styles. That was amazing. That just blew me away. So one of the things I want to tell you about is something that we're doing next Sunday. And again, it's what can you bring to the worship experience and make it a living sacrifice to God. But what we're going to do is we're going to show up in a parking lot, the Chick-fil-A on 60 in Valrico, next Sunday evening at 6:30. And we're just going to have a guitar, somebody singing some songs. Vicky and I will be there to pray and to give a message. And that's the skeleton of it. That's the bare knuckles of it. What are you going to do to bring that living sacrifice to make this worship experience great in the parking lot of a Chick-fil-A on a Sunday evening? What can you do? That's where we'll be next Sunday. So remember that. Couple other announcements I want to leave you with before we take off for the day. New Hope Kids will start up Sunday, September 13th. We will have virtual interaction with your students up until that point. If you need any more information, maybe you haven't received any information about what the students are doing virtually, contact us, leave something on the platform today, say, I haven't heard a thing, I haven't received anything, let me know what's going on, or just contact us at findnewhope.com and we'll give you more information about that. But kids programming starting back September 13th. Believe it or not, that's like a couple of weeks away. As far as Passion Student Ministries, our youth ministry. We are doing it right now. We just had our second Sunday of coming back into the fold. Just a reminder that 9:30, we do basically a small group and connection time. And then at 5 p.m., we do a worship, garage-style worship, that is relative to youth. So you have two options there on Sunday. Come to one or come to both, whatever you want to do. If you're in seventh grade, I want to remind you that you have the possibility of going through our confirmation, which is called Passage, and you are still able to register for that. Yes, you are. So if you need more information on how to register or the information and guidelines as far as our confirmation class goes, go to findnewhope.com, go to our Passion Student Ministry page, and you will see all the information there, or you can just contact me, Chris, at findnewhope.com. A couple of reminders too. We still have our sanctuary open to people for prayer and reflection time, Mondays from 1 to 4, Thursdays 9 to 1. It's an opportunity for you to come in the middle of the week and just have some intimate alone time with God in the sanctuary. It's a great time to just come in and just stop your week and sit down and have some prayer time. We just ask that you keep your social distancing practices in measure, and you wear a mask too. So, and speaking of that, as far as opening our sanctuary back up, we have been doing in-person worship here in our sanctuary on Sundays in our two services, 9 and 10:45. And we were asking people to do an RSVP so we would know how many people are coming in. Well, we have stopped the RSVP. You are allowed to just walk in and grab a seat. Of course, you're going to be led by ushers, and we do all the safety precautions that we need to do to keep social distancing in measure, as well as we ask that you wear a mask. So you don't have to do an RSVP to show up to one of our services. You can just show up. Once again, 9 o'clock and 10:45, 9 o'clock being the more traditional service and 10:45 being sort of the generational, contemporary family service. So, also, I want to remind you that New Hope Early Learning, the registration is going on. School starts tomorrow. Can you believe it? And if you have not signed up your preschool child, or if you're looking for a kindergarten or a VPK, our school has got it. Go to newhopeearlylearning.com. Find out all the information that you need. Maybe even schedule a tour. It's a great school. It's a great early childhood education in a loving and warm Christian environment. And I can't recommend it enough. Also, they are still looking for some supplies. So if you are feeling called or led to donate, consider this. They have a lot of items on their Amazon wish list that they're still looking to get to help the supply for the year for their early learning. And we've had an overwhelming response to it so far, but there are still a lot of stuff that we need. So go to findnewhope.com or newhopeearlylearning.com, and you can receive the information about that. And finally, I just want to remind everybody that if you are getting back into the swing of things with your small group or your Connect group, that we do have a discipleship resource library that is open to you 24/7. You can go online and check out all the availability that we have as far as series, devotions, anything that you're looking for to help with your Connect group, with your small group. A lot of people, they take the summer off. A lot of people have just taken it off altogether, the year off, because of the whole social distancing and stuff. But a lot of people are coming back now, and they're trying to get things together, whether it be virtually or maybe a hybrid version of it where it's in person and virtual, or they're just going back in person. They're taking that leap and doing it. So if that's you, if that's your small group, check out the resources that are available to you. And if you are not involved in a small group or a Connect group, I highly recommend one. It's a great opportunity to be in a community of people that could possibly be some of the best friends you will ever have in your life. And it's all in the journey with God that they be with you and you be with them. And it's an absolutely wonderful thing. And you grow together and you go together. And I think that's what we're looking for. We're looking for the heart of worship too. And the heart of worship is you bringing in something to your worship experience, you becoming that living sacrifice to God to transform yourself into being somewhat in the way that you want to walk with God. So we thank you very much for joining us today. We look forward to seeing you next Sunday. If you have any more questions or any information that you didn't hear today that you want to know about, definitely go to findnewhope.com to receive that. Otherwise, have a blessed week, and we will see you next Sunday.